Baggage woes at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Terminal 3. According to Cebu Pacific, the baggage handling system of the terminal is not working properly, forcing the carrier to process the luggage manually. CEBPAC says passengers were given the option to have their bags delivered to their destination or to have them pick them up at the airport for domestic flights. Now, for international flights, a similar option was given along with delivery services for passengers with onward destinations. As for AirAsia, it said it was able to deploy additional personnel, resulting in no delays in baggage handling so far. Airport operator Nunaia Infra Corporation has yet to issue a statement on the matter. The Philippine Central Bank's Monetary Board approves more public sector foreign borrowings in the third quarter of the year. The figure came in at $3.8 billion. That is 36% higher than the $2.8 billion approved in the same period last year. These consist of a bond issuance and project loans. The BSP said the bond issuance will fund the national government's general budget financing of assets, while the other loans will cover projects on maritime safety and agrarian reform, among others. Now for the latest at the corporate front, yet another project from Mega World. The property giant is building an upscale residential condo, this time in Puerto Princesa, Palawan. The 12-story development in its Baytown Township will offer 188 units. Megaworld expects to rake in some 3 billion pesos in sales from the project, set to be completed by 2030. And to Citicor Renewable Energy Corporation, the company says it is committed to making more investments to expand its wind portfolio in the country. On ANC this morning, C-Rex President and CEO discussed their new partnership with Singapore's Levanta for their 4 onshore wind projects in Luzon and the Visayas. Now, C-Rec is also eyeing to hike the public float of the company once the lockup period ends in December.
The idea is to come up with a base load renewable, pure renewable energy portfolio. So the wind projects will complement our solar. So Levanta, we view them not only as a financial partner, but more of a strategic partner. They will bring in their technical know-how as they have several operating wind projects already in the region. Hmm. This will further complement our local knowledge and engineering know-how.
More revelations into the Duterte drug war at the resumption of a joint Philippine congressional panel inquiry. Now, Tuesday's hearing at the House saw its most high-profile witness yet, in former Senator Leila De Lima. She cited findings as then human rights chief of Rodrigo Duterte as leader of a group of hitmen tasked to kill alleged drug suspects in Davao City. De Lima alleged active duty policemen and rebel returnees received thousands of cash or in cash from Duterte's office as mayor as a reward for the assassinations.
This was impunity as never seen before in the Philippines outside of Davao. After the summary execution of targeted victims, the DDS members would regroup at their safe house and divide the reward. During that time, MRRD sometimes personally gave out the kill orders and the reward money directly to the assassins themselves.
The staunch Duterte critic endured nearly 7 years in jail for illegal drug trade charges, all of which have since been dismissed by the court. De Lima, in her hearing, called for the creation of a so-called truth commission to look into the drug war. Now, she also pushed for the Philippines to rejoin the International Criminal Court, which Duterte withdrew from in 2019.
We should now take steps to retract the self-serving act of Mr. Duterte to withdraw from the ICC. We must return to the fold of the ICC. We must rejoin the community of nations who have recognized the need for an international body of nations to go after the perpetrators of the most terrible crimes against humanity, the hostis humani generis, the enemies of humankind. Mga kaaway lamang ng sangkatauhan ang takot sa pagsasanib puwersa ng mga bansa upang matigil ng pagpatay ng walang habas sa ngalan ng Estado.